Mini chapter 23, Jaymi creates Evelyn's appearance. Wow, so all that kind of thing is going to be possible through this beast creating business. Bring it on then. There'll be more home visits to the Dreary Ones, most certainly. But first, here in the red-green-blue glassiness of the Melrose Avenue building, on this sober morning after Amber's first meat-space jaunt, there is different work to be done. Jaymi closes his eyes and thinks back to that unique half-minute when he let his gaze wander up and down the Galscore, Babe or Gross newsfeed, where new posts were popping up every few seconds, every one of them receiving scores and comments from multiple sources. Then he reopens his eyes, consults the notes he's been making over the last couple of days for the Imagination Thief, and checks his sketch for her visuals. Its first description of Evelyn's physical appearance reads, quote, "There's that sleek little van. And in the driver's window, the face of a Latina in her 20s smiles out at me, smooth, sunny, round, with a faint sass within its clear warmth. This must be the mysterious Evelyn Carmello. Hi, Jaymi, she calls. I like her straight away. Ellipsis. I don't know, I say. Should we cancel? She raises her eyes and points behind her to the van door. Unquote. There is then one further little artwork-oriented description of her a bit later on. Quote, he saw you as wild, free, and self-sufficient, walking with a sway through the beauty of the night, like a part of the night itself, a sweet, sexy woman whom he passed at a corner. Ellipsis. He saw you as embodying how lovingness and warmth could exist in a natural and instinctive form, whatever kind of place it found itself. And when he looked in your eyes, then he felt plugged into a warm, electric fountain of rich brown light. Unquote. For yes, Evelyn's recent prophecy of her own eye colour was, as it happens, wrong. In her artwork, each iris does not fade smoothly in from black around its outer rim to green around the pupil, as she herself prophesied. The iris is just brown. Though just brown is perhaps reductive, because in contrast with the smooth uniformity of the black-to-green fade she had proto-sensed, each iris crams so much subtle complexity of visual design into the width between its two concentric borders that a sublimely edible colour spectrum is spanned by the glints inside the brown. From orange flower water, through a rich amber rum, to the oft-sung but mysterious Chica Cherry Cola, taking a joyfully cheap detour through strawberry lemonade, then refining again to a sweet red wine of the kind that should take the place of water in a bong, infusing each marijuana bubble with vinous fumes, and at the spectrum's most exotic end, the faintest scintillation of violet-flavoured champagne. Nor are solid comestibles omitted, for again within the glints of Evelyn's brown irises is an equivalent colour feast, from sugar, sweet and raw, in amber tarts ringed with crystals of treacle, through grapefruit sorbet with yellow chartreuse poured over it, to this spectrum's own most exotic end in a hint of violet mousse. Her flavours trigger scents, and her scents trigger flavours, tingling at his fingertips and whispering aloud around the edges of his vision.